Okay, hopefully this goes well. This is like my 1 millionth take, and I don't know, a lot is just happening in my mind, and my mind is everywhere, and I'm trying so hard to contain my thoughts, but like I feel like my brain is moving faster than my mouth, and I can barely like articulate myself, and I just hit my teeth with my teeth with my nails. I don't know if you guys heard that. Is so weird. I'm sorry. Okay. This is something that I've been wanting to talk about for the longest time ever, and I'm finally excited that I can finally like make this video because I feel like I always overthink about it, and I'm like, no, I need to like write down notes and I need to know what I want to say and stuff. But honestly, I don't know what I want to say, but I just want to say something because like this is like it's too much in my head. I need to like say it out loud or else I'm gonna go crazy. You guys know, like if anyone knows me well enough, they would know that I'm very passionate about like being in my 20s because guys, I am a str I'm not struggling, but like it's just so surreal and it's so scary and it's also like so much like I don't know how to explain it, but it's something that's like consuming the whole, like my entire life right now because obviously I am in this period, and so I'm gonna talk about it any chance I get, okay? But I feel like ever since I left high school, life has been so different. It's been such a huge eye opener, going to varsity, you meet different people from different backgrounds. That's why I think going to varsity is so important. You meet so many different people from different backgrounds. You live at res and you see how differently people live from like how you're used to your families. And growing up, I wasn't allowed to go for sleepovers. And so I did not know how other people lived until I went to varsity. And I was like, oh, okay. It's like the little things like, oh, you cook like this. Oh, you guys do this. And it's always like a culture shock. Almost like a, oh, okay. So, like, because obviously, when you're like used to a certain way, you think everybody, like, I was convinced everybody lived like that, like us, And so, when you like, you realize that there's so much more to life than you already know. And so, I don't know, ever since then, everything has just been so overwhelming because I don't know. I low key miss being sheltered and being protected from all these things because now, I don't know. It feels too much to digest. Now it's kind of like, okay, now I need to pick because obviously my parents raised me a certain way. And so obviously they also had this culture shock and then they had to like pick which, okay, fine, this is how we raise our children. This is how we choose to live. And so now I'm exposed to like all these different things and all these different options, all these different, and it's overwhelming, guys. It's overwhelming. And I feel like people are not talking about this enough, like being in your 20s is so overwhelming because for like you're supposed to live, do the most, and I feel like I'm not doing enough. Obviously I'm not talking about clubbing and all those things, but I feel like I'm not out there enough, like traveling. People are traveling, they're going to Cape Town, they're doing this. Next week someone posted they're there and you're like, am I not doing enough with my 20s? Am I going to look back in 10 years when I'm 30? Because I feel like that's how social media and like everyone around us and society kind of displays how life will turn out. It's like once you turn 30, then like you must have children, settle down, you're not living anymore, and and so now like I feel like all the like in our 20s we're like fidgeting. You're like, oh my word, I need to like do all these things before I expire, and it's such like there's so much pressure that comes with that because first of all you're trying to like understand this life on your own. You're trying to like grasp this life and you're trying to like it's like you're just barely trying to hold on to anything and like there's so much happening and you're like, okay guys, wait, let's pause, everybody stop the music. Okay, explain what's happening. Let's debrief. Let's talk about our feelings. Yeah, do you approve of this happening to you, Carol? No, we don't have that. That does not exist. It's like go. Okay, high school finishes, cool, go to university. University finishes, cool, go to work. And it's like you're working and you're like, okay, fine, like let me just wait, let me just breathe. And they're like, no, you have to get to work Monday, be at work. And you're like, oh my word. And so it's like I'm very grateful for like being able to have all these opportunities, but at the same time, I kind of like have trouble letting go of the freedom of being a kid. But also, it wasn't necessarily freedom because you were told what to do. And now everything is in my hands, and I feel like I have to make all these choices, and my life feels like it's in my hands, and I don't want my life to be in my hands, bro. Like, I'm just a girl. But it feels like whatever I do now, whatever you do now, Carol, like it feels like every single day I have to wake up and whatever I do today depicts my whole life. Like, my whole life stands on what I do today. It's like there's so much power in my hands right now for my life, and I'm like, I'm sorry, take it back. I don't want it. I'm very scared. I don't know what I'm doing. Like, we don't know what we're doing, and I feel like as much as we're not getting guidance, because I feel like after a certain extent our parents are like, okay, you got this now, cool, you know. No, I don't got this, mom. I need you to tell me to go to sleep at 9, you know? And now it's like, oh no, I'm not going to tell you to go to sleep at 9. Like, you can sleep at whatever time you want to sleep. It's on you. You know what time you have to wake. So it's like, I must now decide, okay, I have to sleep at 9 because I know tomorrow I'm going to struggle with waking up. Like, no, I want my mommy to tell me that. I want her to be like, Carol, go to sleep or I'm going to take your phone, type of thing. But now it's like, it's all up to you. It's like, okay, Carol, you can go to sleep at 9 if you want to. And if you don't, you don't. But you'll deal with the consequences tomorrow morning, type of thing. And I don't know. And it's obviously more than that. It's more than, like, I'm not only talking about, like, going to sleep. But I hope you guys get what I'm trying to say. But, yeah, I genuinely, like, miss high school so bad, and that scares me because I'm realizing how much I struggle with moving on, letting go of the past and living in the present. I feel like I'm holding on to old me so much, and old memories and old behaviors, and I'm like, I don't want to let go of this. Like, no, don't take my childhood away from me. But I feel like it's slowly fading, and I'm slowly entering this new phase of my life, and I don't want to, and I have to, but I want to, but also I'm so scared of, like, leaving behind all those, like, not that I'm leaving behind the memories, obviously, but it just feels like things are changing now. Deal with it. And my mommy knows that I'm very bad with taking, just like, with dealing with change. Like, I will hold on to the current so much because it's so familiar, it's so safe, it's so comfortable. Like, I always want to be comfortable, and so change always makes me so nervous because I'm like, I can't predict it. I don't know what's going to happen. And it's just so scary. I'm not used to it. I'm not familiar with it. You know, the old phase, the old part of my life, I knew it. I could predict what was going to happen. I felt like I was in control. But I feel like as I'm entering this new stage, I'm out of control. But at the same time, I have to be in control. Like, I don't know if I'm explaining this properly. But I just, yeah, I get panic attacks every after 2 hours. Okay, I'm lying, but like, I'm just like always in this state of panic, and you have to go to work the next day and pretend everything is fine, and you have to smile. And I remember, I feel like I'm very well at hiding this. I'm not trying to say that I'm miserable, no, but I feel like at the back of my mind, I'm always like in the state of panic. I'm always so anxious. Like, I'm extremely anxious because I'm like, there's no way, like, all this is happening, and I'm trying to process everything. And I go to work and I try so hard to put a smile on my face. And so many people at work actually have told me, like, not too long, like this week, this one guy was like, you're always smiling. Like, what's your trick to always being this happy? And I'm like, if only you knew how anxious I feel right now. If only you knew how bad I want to cry right now. But I can't because I'm at work. And I literally, like, now it's not as bad anymore. But literally when I started this job, I had just relocated from one province to another. A province that I do not know. I do not know anyone here. It's far from anyone I know. And I remember every day when I came back from work, I would literally sob. And I would literally, like, I remember this one time I took lunch, like during lunch, I literally like drove away and I was literally went to a parking lot and I cried. And I came back and I was like, "How are you doing, everybody? It's a good day." Because it's just, it feels like it's a lot and no one cares. Literally, that's what it feels like. It feels like I'm dealing with so much right now. I'm dealing with change. I'm dealing with all these things. But it's also like no one cares. No one cares what you're dealing with. Do your job and get it done. We don't care how you feel. And the world does not care. The sun does not care. If I feel super bad, if I want to cry, it does not care. It will rise and set. And if I want to stay in bed, it will leave me behind. And it's just so painful. Like that realization is so painful that, like, oh, I feel so bad and stuff, but no one cares type of thing. Like, deal with it. And yeah, basically, that's been my, like, yeah, that's been what's been happening lately. And it feels like no one cares and no one understands. That's what it feels like. And I try to not have this like victim mindset, because obviously I have to like go to work and stuff. I'm not gonna like take leave and be like, I was sad. Sorry, boss. I was sad yesterday because I'm 20. Like, oh, and it's so overwhelming. Like, and so that's why I wake up every morning and I choose to smile and I choose to just pretend as if everything is fine, because no one cares. No one cares if you're having a bad day. Of course, they're gonna be like, oh, that's sad. But at the end of the day, they don't care. Get your work done. Do what you need to do, type of thing. And that's kind of like the harshest realities I've had to deal with. And so, yeah, but I truly believe that we'll be okay. I try as much as I can to live in the moment and be present. But at the same time, it feels pointless. It feels pointless to be happy right now, because I'm like, what's the, like, it's like, what's the point of being happy right now if tomorrow I'm gonna forget? Like, what's the point of experiencing something nice now if tomorrow out of focus? Like, I don't know if I'm explaining this properly, but yeah, I just feel alone because no one cares. So yeah, man, thank you so much for watching and thank you for listening to my vent session. And yeah. That is how it feels being in your 20s. The wonderful panickies. Yeah. And there's this video that trended last year. And it was like something about like the panic years, the panic to live your best life or whatever. I'm not gonna try to quote what she said, but I related so much to that video. And I wish I could just stop overthinking and stop being so anxious and just be free and just live my life, but I can't because I'm just an anxious person. Okay, I shouldn't claim such. I'm not claiming it. I'm not an anxious person. Ew. Away with anxiety. Guys, I'm gonna end this video here. Thank you so, so much for watching. And if you're going through the same thing, I'm sorry. We're gonna be okay. Yeah. I try my best to live my life, and I think life's been good. Life's been great. Am I dying inside half the time? Yes. Life's good. Life's good. 10 out of 10 recommend. We should do this again. Yeah. If you're older, please do leave like some advice down below for the youngsters like us who are suffering. Thank you. And goodbye.